Is NASA lying to us? What is happening? Antarctica is gaining ice? What? Global warming? How? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to DNews today. I'm Trace. Commonly during these climate change, global warming conversations, people point at the horizon and shout, "The polar ice caps are melting." But guess what? They're not. NASA says so. In fact, according to new research, Antarctica has gained so much ice, it's overbalanced for the ice that the continent has lost. From 1992 to 2001, the continent gained more ice than it lost to melting, 112 billion tons every year. So wait, if global warming is real, how come Antarctica's ice is thickening? Okay, so I apologize for the slightly clickbaity headline, but to be honest, whether or not scientists are lying to us is, that's a real question. But did anybody lie? No, internet buddies. They didn't. In fact, this ice research is consistent with other papers climatologists have released. In 2013, NASA's Earth Observatory announced Antarctic sea ice had set a new record. Another study said the same thing in 2012. There's more sea ice now than the 1981 to 2010 average levels. I know what you're thinking, because I thought the same thing. If the globe is warming, how can Antarctica be gaining ice? Okay, so don't believe the hype. Research still states unequivocally, Antarctica is losing ice at a fantastic rate across most of the continent. Ice has increased in East Antarctica and the interior of West Antarctica, but other parts of Antarctica are still melting a lot, a lot, a lot. So let's be clear, gaining sea ice at this point is actually bad. Yeah, you heard me, it's bad. Well, there's this annual cycle of sea ice, melt and freeze, where the ice is at its lowest point in February and March, and thickest in September and October. According to a new, not yet published paper from a NASA Goddard scientist brought to our attention by Discovery News writer Patrick J. Kiger, global warming and climate change are actually increasing sea ice. See, melting glaciers have been depositing fresh water into the Southern Ocean. And if you think back to seventh grade science, which freezes first, salt water for fresh water. Exactly. Fresh water does. Salt water has a much lower freezing point. It can get colder before it will freeze. This paper's conclusion is the top layer of water surrounding Antarctica has been diluted by the massive freshwater melt from the ice shelves, and therefore it freezes more easily today than in previous decades. This accounts for the increase in sea ice. The 2012 study found a 1.5% increase in sea ice accumulation over the decade. And this isn't the only paper that reaches that conclusion. According to a 2012 paper in Nature, which also predicted this effect, it is happening even more quickly in the real world than it did in their models, which is even more troubling. In a few more years, the new author, James Hansen, said, "This will of course be clearer because the sea ice will continue to expand." Even worse, however, is the overall ice trend is still more melty than it is freezy. It's melting and freezing, and then melting and then freezing. Plus, salt water underneath the freshwater dilution is still warming thanks to the overall climate trend. NASA scientists are quick to say that it is very difficult to accurately measure all of these things because of snow levels sitting atop the ice and the constantly changing landscape of such a large area as the continent of Antarctica. The big learning from this, though, is that even though the UN announced in 2013 a 0.27 millimeter per year sea level rise across the Earth and blamed it on increasing sea ice, there's obviously more here than meets the eye. NOAA says, yes, the seas are rising. The thing is, now we aren't 100% sure why, which is almost more scary if you think about it. Moving forward, scientists know that they have to learn more about what is causing sea level rise because it might not just be ice melt of Antarctica. The oceans have warmed about 0.1 Celsius over the last century, in the top 700 meters alone. And though that seems small, that's just an average. Something so small over something as large as the ocean could completely change the topography, weather, and expected behavior of the single largest entity on Earth. Whoa. So, climate people, who I assume have already left this video huffing and hoeing, more sea ice doesn't mean no global warming, but in fact, more global warming. You're welcome. Sincerely, your friend Science. How are you all feeling about this, though? Tell me down in the comments, and check out DiscoveryNews.com's piece on this as well. And if you're concerned about what would happen if all the ice in the world would melt, Julia assuages your concerns over here. Or maybe she doesn't. You're gonna have to watch the video and find out.
If all the ice in the Greenland ice sheet melts, global sea levels would rise by about 24 feet. If all of Antarctica melts, sea levels would rise by 200 feet. The entire eastern seaboard of the US would be underwater and Florida would vanish.
Guys, Test Tube now has a newsletter. You can get a weekly roundup of all of our most popular videos across all of our shows. Check it out at testtube.com/FWD. How are y'all feeling about this? Tell me down in the comments and come back here every day for more DNews. Thanks for watching.